Okay, the first letter that you have there on your desk was the letter written by Maazi Uchemefo, signed by Maazi Uchemefo, and stamped by Maazi Uchemefo as the deputy leader of Biafran Movement, IPOB, led by Maazi Nnamdi Kanu. Our leader's signature was not there. He wrote that letter to the authority of United Kingdom. They call them Home Office. It's the Home Office that will give you your document, either to stay here or reject it to leave. Once they reject it, they will tell you you have maybe 90 days or 3 months to speak to your lawyer and to petition, reapply, or go, contest it. If it is being rejected again, that means they are definite that you are not going to be granted what you are asking for. So over the years, since when these international communities began to recognize the killings of Biafra, the genocide Nigeria is committing, and the one they committed, and the one they will commit in the future, so they started giving Biafrans asylum, granting them political asylum to reside in the United Kingdom. And Uchemefo went through that process. Uzoka went through that process. And so many of them went through that process. So when this thing began, Uchemefo sent a letter to the United Kingdom Home Office saying that this thing shouldn't be given to people because those people are not, some of them are not eligible. Uchemefo cannot prove it because he's not working with immigration. Yes, hello?
Yeah, I can hear you. Go ahead, please.
Okay. He isn't working with immigration, so he doesn't have the eligibility criteria. And this the person who even went and stood for some of them that we are asking for this asylum document to be granted because most of them are not documented. When you are undocumented in a country, that means you are illegal in that country. So because of this quest of our project, our national coordinator abandoned. Remember, he's a orthopedic doctor. He will leave his job, leave everything, and was running around taking our people, trying to help them to get documented so that they can be working. For those of us in Biafran land and other part of Africa that doesn't know how this thing works, if you are not documented, you are not going to have a job. The system will not give you job, because if you go for employment, they will ask you your NI. Your NI is your national insurance. In other country, they call them a SOFI number, like in the Dutch, they call them SOFI number, and in America, they call it Social Security number. Without Social Security number, you cannot get employment, because you will not pay your tax. They take the tax before the money get into your account. The state will take their tax. So that is why it is very important that you should be documented. You should have your legality. So when our national coordinator was going around interviewing people, seeing how they are suffering, and presenting the case to the Home Office now began to grant them. Uchemefo, seeing what our national coordinator has been doing, and this process, our national coordinator went and stood for Maazi Uzoka to get his document, and some other folks, to my understanding and knowledge, to get their documents. Once they got the document, they began to fight the same man that took them there, that stood for them and took some certain interview and to confirm their eligibility. Of course, those people that he was coming with are their friends. They are the victims. He never manipulated anything. He presented the case the way it is. And remember, the very particular man is well-to-do, well-established. He grew up here, so he doesn't know corruption. He doesn't, he is, if you close your eyes when this man is talking, you will think he's a white British man talking. Sorry to use the name white, because we are human beings. You will think he's a white British man talking. And when he talks to you, even if you want to go 1 mile, you will go for that man extra miles. Because he has the ability to communicate to people. He doesn't feel that too big. He doesn't have big manism in him. If you see him, you will know that this man is called naturally by God to serve people. And remember, he's a medical, he's a doctor here, qualified. Not yesterday, with many years of experience. And some people that doesn't even get to the level where this man is will be talking down on him. It really shocked me how I have their names. I have their names. They will be throwing words because they want position. I had it, I was upset. Lord, if this thing has been applied long ago, these guys will not be here talking. They won't do this, that before they will come to this thing, this damaging thing they think they can do, they would have been flushed out long ago. I presented it to most of the top guys in the DOS. This is what they're doing here. And he wrote, Ushemefo now single-handedly wrote to Home Office to stop them from granting that thing to people that it is being manipulated and it's not true. So if this man is, if you ask me, I will tell every Biafran that that man is working for the zoo. Yes, because you cannot issue such letter to stop your people from getting documented and have the legality to live and work here and pay tax here. You can't do that. Sierra Leonean went through it, and they were even bringing Sierra Leonean to come and get their, they will even beg them to come and get their papers fixed so that they can start working and be sending money to their families back home in Sierra Leone. Liberians did it, and they will bring their people and begin to beg them. Some of them were ignorant, so begin to beg them to go up through this procedure and get documented so they can begin to work and pay their taxes and send some of the remaining money to their families to be feeding, because they were going through economic crisis because of war, because of killings. And this man didn't think about the people. He only thinks that he has gotten his own, and he will close the doors for other people. He also wrote telling them in that document that the office of Dr. Lois Ukashi, the national coordinator of UK, is not recognized by the indigenous people of Biafra. Our leader never said so. Ushemefa said so and wrote it and sealed and stamped it and sent it to Home Office. That is when our DOS should have unleashed mayhem on Ushemefa. That is why I got upset with some of them. They will be looking at things. They will be looking at things. Things will be deteriorating and they will be looking at it. And they will not, because they want to be Santa Mwebe. I want to please somebody. At the detriment of your people, at the death of your people, you want to please somebody. These people that are contributing their monthly due, some of them are undocumented, trying to survive. They are Biafrans. Some of their families have been massacred, killed by Nigerian government. Some of them are wanted by Nigeria. No one will give them voice to speak. Only IPOB, led by Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, is giving them voice to speak. To tell the world their plight and tell them how they are suffering. Before you can undertake and do anything in Europe, you have to be legally documented. Go through the procedure, they will give you documents. Some of them will say you are recognized to live and work in United Kingdom, but you cannot take social security, like benefit. Yes, you cannot take benefit, but you can work here. So if you prove yourself strong and remain focused. You can work for 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. You can present your case again to them and tell them, because they're human beings, they're white people, they have understanding. They are very considerate. You say, I have worked here for 3 good years. I've paid my taxes. I am married with children. Why can't my children get support? It's like you are using my money to pay other people. I need the same, benefit. When I lose my job, I will be supported. When my children are not, when my wife is not feeling well, she will get supported. They can contribute to pay the rent so that we won't be outside, be thrown out by landlords. So the government will do, when you follow that procedure, they may give you everything at a go. They may choose to give you the legality to live and work in UK and not to collect benefit for a while. If you live and prove yourself, responsible, you have never been involved in any kind of criminal activity, they will give you whatever you are looking for. They are very considerate people. This is the office where Mazi Shemefo wrote a letter saying that he is not sure this thing is being done appropriately. By as a result of that, the office of national coordinator is not recognized and is now removed from that office. That anything coming out of that office is illegal. He wrote that letter. That is the letter in front of you, Mazi Obilo. And the office, other letters he wrote to the same home office about his own people. So this is the man who gets £4,000 plus from IPOB movement, and their friends are contributing to his sustenance. I am not against him being supported, because as a broadcaster or as a certain principal officer, you must be supported so that you don't go looking for a job, get distracted, and when you come on air, you will start snoring and sleeping, which many people will testify that Ushemefo was doing that. Even when he was supported, he will come on air, he will start. I remember the lady that spoke to me in Manchester 2017, that she's leaving because of Mazi Shemefo, who will be on radio and be telling only next caller please, and when the next caller will start speaking, you will hear somebody snoring from the background of the studio. Who was that? Ushemefo. And he was getting paid for snoring on the studio. And the next thing you will see is arrogant, full of arrogance and pride. Most of the people is attacking with his cohorts. Those people are more qualified than him. It is the same IPOB that sponsored him to go and study law. And the rounding it up, what did he do to the movement? Look at what he has done. I remember when Obeta was handling cases right there, the family was telling him in UK, remove this man, let this man, we mess things up. He refused, because why? He was a friend, or he's a friend to Obeta. Even in that Zoom they had on Sunday, I saw a man with the name Obeta on the screen talking. I don't know whether it's him or the relative of that Obeta. This is the same man. And we refuse to call a spade a spade. This is the reason why I say to some of us that be very careful. There are those that I'm looking at. They will come and tell you all sorts of lies you believe you don't. And he's a member of IPOB. But he's a liar. Some of them are liars. If somebody tell you anything, you cannot verify it. You just jump and start talking. And tomorrow he said, you and I are comrades. Comrade. You are not a man enough to verify or to investigate report before you start ranting. That is why I said there are those that will kick themselves out of this movement, and Biafra will come. So these are the things this guy did to the movement and the family. Our leader does. I don't even expect him to come and talk about this man, because there are those that will come on air and disclose what Ushemefo has been doing. Our leader wants to carry everybody along. He doesn't want issue. Even I can tell you, I don't want to go to this far. I remember, you know, our leader's wife is a woman that hardly talk. I have my intelligence. I put Umu Egentis on the ground listening. Which before, I remember the day we had, we finalized the parents. I saw what happened there. I saw a true deputy leader, you are isolating yourself to your people. Your people became your enemy. You became better than them. Go, I will give you a very simple test. Yes, you have gotten your papers right now. You can fly around the world, Abi, which you must be for. Take a trip to South Africa and let them take you to Simon Street. You say, I want to see ANC hackers, how they behave. Somebody called me yesterday and said, there are some certain things, you ask them, they will tell you, this information is not made true. ANC guys, they won't give you any information. You don't hear anything. They're very formidable. I respect them so much. Regardless of what is going on now, I respect ANC so much for how they are conducting their operation till today. And people, forget the names that people are calling. I know no family is perfect. But IPOB remain the greatest of it all. The greatest of it all. Mazin Nnamdi the Kanu, greater than the greatest. God is the greatest. And besides God, I'm talking, don't get me wrong. Because tomorrow he said, we are giving him a name above God. Among all those that fought for freedom, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu remained the greater than the greatest. I applaud him. He's a man of principle, man of integrity, man of a good heart. I understand that some people don't like his mannerism of communication, especially when he called some certain people, maybe say idiot or idiot everywhere, or foolish people everywhere. Don't get upset because John the Baptist called so many people bad names. That is how those men are. When God gives them this, they are operating in a higher altitude and a higher frequency. So if you make mistake, they won't understand you because they believe that you can stand till the end. That's how the man is. So people think that he's a monster. When he goes home, he's lashing on the wife. It's not true. It's a lovely man. It's a lovely man. And that's why these people are talking here and there, because they are not getting information. They want to sell the information. They want to sell the information to the zoo. Run the radio station, Leslie. For on the radio station, Team Biafran, the way Nigeria addresses Biafrans, saying they are court members, they are terrorists. That is what Nigeria calls Biafrans. When we gather to pray, they will come there in the church or in the gathering and shoot all of us. This man keep calling our people names. He called a coordinator's wife. I know a coordinator in Croydon. He shouted at his wife, calling him, hey, hey, hey. You call yourself a leader, and you don't love your people. Madam Nnenyanya will never say that I didn't send her a clip last year. I sent her a clip last year. Mr. Abuanyim can never say that I never sent him a clip also, or he never heard me talking about this incident. Where you can have someone who said, that is when I said it, I will say it on air. I don't wish anything to happen to our leader. But anything, if he resigns, say I'm not going to be this, let another person take place. I will never live to see that Ushemefo be taking the leadership of IPOB. He doesn't have the criteria and he doesn't have the mind. He doesn't love his people. If you say it, will you perish? You can send me off, I don't care. But I have told Biafrans, I have been fighting this monster for a very long time. I did investigate this monster or monsters for a very long time. I said, if you are very loving and caring about your people, you will never think of yourself. Our leader sacrificed heavily, gave up everything God gave him. Gave up his life for Biafra. A lot of people gave their life for this struggle. Some are giving their life for the struggle. And just because you feel that you are not informed, you feel that information is not given to you. That is what so information you are looking for, what are you going to do with it? Whom do you want to give the information to? Ask yourself questions, Devon. The information you are looking for that made you to go to this level, what do you want to give? Whom do you want to give that information to? And what do you want to do with that information? If someone else is not talking to you, if third party is not talking to you, why are you seeking for the information? It's a question any intelligent man will ask himself or herself. Then I got worried about this fellow. He went further. He called even everyone that listened to National Coordinator. He's an occult member. Imagine that. He called, he said in his broadcast that day, he said, who is Mazio Former? Who are you? That's what he said. I asked Mazio Former a question. He didn't answer me. He just forwarded a lot of transcript. I read it. I shook my head. Listen to, dear friends, listen very carefully before you go astray. I'm sorry for anyone that is listening to these idiots. I am telling them, I'm telling us point blank on air. Anyone that listening to this man, I don't know the God that created your brain. We let me say this. The people you are insulting are the one paying you. I never get paid to fight for my liberation. I put what I have to liberate myself. Uchemefo, you get paid to fight for your liberation. Biafra trained you. Through Biafra, you got your document to reside in United Kingdom. Through Biafran agitation and the blood of Biafran, you apply for nationality. Who knows how far it has gone, or you got it, they give it to you because you promise you're going to sabotage this, that you have the capability of doing it. But let me tell you and your cohorts, watch and see what is going to happen. I am very much aware of what I'm saying. I follow them systematically. If we begin to do our job, we are very patient. We will let you do everything you can before we will come for you. Biafran, the blood of Biafrans gave you your status. IPOB under Mazin Nnamdi Kanu gave you your status. You began to have UN passport. Come on, my friend. You never worked for it from outside and got your documentation and come inside IPOB. The people you are attacking, the medical doctor and the other professionals you are attacking have already been established in the particular country in UK where they are. And they are contributing for the liberation of Biafrans around the world and those in Biafra, and to liberate our people from the monster called the Niger area, Nigeria. You get paid to do what you are doing. So you are a higher servant. You are a high confirmed higher servant. You are not a natural freedom fighter. Tell me people that you have blessed willingly, that you never know, that are not working for you negatively. As a result of that, you are giving them money. Anyone you give any money, there is a deadly job the person is doing for you. I have their names. But when we come, we will tell you the people, when the time comes, everybody will give account. Some people have put millions of naira into the struggle willingly. They are professionals. You get paid to do even broadcast. You have the temerity to ask the leader to increase your money, and their fans are dying. This man will sleep in the car while you are sleeping in the house. Our leader Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, he said it. You probably have heard about it. Uchemefo, you are not closer to your people. You don't love Biafrans. You treat them with a kind of attitude because you don't know what struggle is all about. You are not reaching out for them. You don't show love on them. You talk down on them. You put them down thinking you are, I will never, if this is, I am, I came because I had Mazina at the camp. I had him talking. I came like any other person. I will never hear your voice and step out. I will never. I'm an Anambra man, if you don't know. My father is an Anambra man, as they call us. So you are not different from any other Anambra. Don't get yourself confused. You don't get yourself. When Ojukwu Ojukwu gave what his father left for him, for Biafra, took his money and was sponsoring everything. He never complained. That is why he's loved all over the world by Biafrans. He's loved. And you never did this. You never gone to that level. Our leader could have stayed in United Kingdom and enjoyed the love and the wealth that God gave him and that he worked for. He left it and came down to Biafran land and was moving around. I saw what could have happened to him in Ebonyi. They could have taken him down, but Elohim said, no. I sent you. It's not going to happen that way. It's not going to happen. And they couldn't do it. When they mustered courage and ganged up, they went to his house and they took lives away. In this very crucial time, I never heard this man coming out on air saying what they are doing to our people down there. I didn't like it. There are many principal officers, even some hosting radio, that was into this crime, to this criminality, love of money. And people were donating money to these people worldwide. And they never loved their people. And they kept saying, if you remove me from here, I will collapse the movement. How dare you? Are you God? It's Elohim that set up the movement. And you said you will collapse what God set up. You will collapse your life. While you are thinking about it, everything in your organ will begin to fail you. This is what these guys are talking about. I remember when I warned somebody who is now running his mouth in part of Europe. Don't send anything to this idiot. These people want to destroy this movement. They never wanted Biafra to come. They want it to remain like this. They are the ones sitting on radio, ranting and shouting and insulting Yoruba people. I came, I spoke to them. I spoke to Biafra and said, reduce your this attack missiles. This is not the way to fight for freedom. You have to align with these people. They are human beings that are created by God. Yorubas are formidable. They are good in their things as God gave them gifts. We have to use this, combine all this effort, this thing that God gave us and endowed us with this gifting. We combine it and go and take what belongs to us. Even the jaws, the rivers, the calabars, the ethics, the bibios, the securities, the robos, the domas, and those that are in the middle belt. Though if I don't mention your name, I said it, I did consultation, a general began to talk to me, said, this is a very simple formula that you guys going to use, because everyone in that region is being oppressed. And the people oppressing you are not many. So why don't you team up together and fight your common enemy and destroy them? You get your liberation. Once you are liberated, you can discuss how you want to live. Because these are the people, the canker worms, the perma worms, the caterpillars killing us. That is what a general told me. I said it on air. And there was a time I came on air somewhere last year. I said, musicians, stop calling names in your music. This is freedom fighting. Stop calling, praising people that are not eligible for that praise. It's only Mazin Lambikano, the one that has been tested and trusted. Any other person, just shut it down and make your music. Tell the world what is happening. You guys contributed to this nonsense. That time I was seeing this thing that you are seeing now, as at that time. Because pride goes before a fall. Stop praising people that when the test of time comes, they will collapse. So your music is irrelevant. You can't play that music in any Biafran radio platform anymore. All your wasted effort and time, your talent, you just throw it in the mud because you don't allow Elohim to lead you in what you're doing. And it's only our leader that you can use his name to do campaign, to make music, to do anything, freedom fighting. Let the enemy hear his name and collapse. But not any other person. I can tell us, I happen to know what I'm saying. Let me use this. Let me give this illustration. ANC never had deputy leaders. Each time there is any issue, they will gather together and decide what will happen in the organization. Even the other ordinary people, lay ordinary members, let me not say element, ordinary members of ANC doesn't know anything that happens internally within the movement. But they trusted their leaders. They trusted the leader who happened to be in prison at that time. And they never gave up. So when Nigerians begin to compare themselves with South Africa, I always tell them to shut up. These South Africans are more formidable than you guys. South Africans, it's Nigeria that is trying to corrupt them in taking bribes. South African doesn't know what bribe is. I can repeat what I'm saying. South Africans originally don't know what bribe is. You don't bribe them. They are not Christians, so they are not Pentecostals. They are people that uphold their belief system. They are moralists in a way, but they don't take bribes. Nigeria began to corrupt them. Normally, I don't want to say this. I don't want to be pushed. But let me say this, because some doubt want to hear it the way it is. Initially, in the early 90s, if you happen to go to nightclub and bring a South African woman home, after you have spent time with her, when she's going in the morning, you give her something like 500 rands, 1,000 rands to go home. She will go down and use that what part of the money and call police for you. And the police will come and she will say, you offered her money, that you are calling her Makosha. Makosha is a prostitute. She wouldn't take. She said, I give it to you freely because I like you. I didn't give it to you for you to pay me. South Africans today, people are calling names. People are calling names. They said they will tell you, and police will arrest you. South Africa SAPS will arrest you. Naturally. Say, did you offer money for sex? You see how moral, how but South Nigerians and some other folks, we call them names. They're morally loose. They're this, they're that. They ended up corrupting them. Anywhere corruption goes, corruption stains the place, environment. So what I'm trying to say is that these people held on to the struggle. They never capitulated. They don't give information out. Nobody is crying out, oh, you sidelined me. I don't know what is happening. Why? I said many times, I suggested our leader through someone, do not tell anybody what you are doing. We believe you. Do not come on air and begin to tell us what you are doing with anything, whatever finance. I don't care because I love this man. I trust him. Even if he will eat me, let him eat me because he deserves to eat me though. Because I haven't attempted what he has achieved. I never attempted it. And he is very transparent. Can I tell Biafrans, if you don't know, some people think he's living in a five-star hotel. Enjoy. When this man came to Israel, I know how he was living there. You guys don't know anything. You don't know anything. Somebody is coming up. Oh, he's the money you are donating. Their mind is always in that money. And Mazi Obilo, let me stop here. If you ask me anything about the document, I will have something to say about that document that you have. Ndewo Mazi Obilo. Before I come back to this 100 men of a thing, there's something that flashed in my spirit now. I want to bring it up. I hope I'm coming out clear, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, I can hear you. Please go ahead.
Okay, good. It doesn't take me long to know a good man and a bad man. I don't mean gender, a good person and a bad person. Let me put it that way. You know, the man in Australia, Mazio Foreman, If you want to hear, if you want to know a gentleman, I've never met him in person. Mazio Foreman is a complete gentleman, a very disciplined man. I hear him talk most of the time. I've had discussions with him. Mazio Foreman. If you want to, not because it's from a particular area that they that area they produce the wisest Igbo men. Not because of that. Because of his nature, the way he will see his heart. This Mazi Ofoma, when I spoke to him, I said, "What is going on?" He said, "Hold on." I forwarded some conversation and everything to my system. I looked at it. I screamed. I said, "Really? Which MFO even I told Ofoma? No, I worry all. Somebody in Australia." Now, what I'm doing, I'm going to go. His comrade. I'm going to go. You took oath. Myself, I'm going to go. I'm going to go. I'm going to go. What has gone into? I didn't even ask that because I saw it already. It has any freedom fighter. Let me tell you, take a trip to the family where the person came from. You will see from the family, the background, you can be able to grade someone. Even if they flash you anything, will you fall for it? A former is a perfect gentleman I've ever encountered. I have heard from him audibly. I have seen him via Zoom network or so. It's, I don't walk by sight. I walk by what the spirit of Elohim tells me. And with my God-given intelligent brain, then I can see whom you are. And this person that cannot guide his utterances, cannot culture his utterances, doesn't know how to carry his own people, show them love. Come to air or whatever and said me like a little child. People use that word like a woman. Don't say that, please. Women, some women are more formidable than some men. Some women are very hardcore than some men. No, a child that is still not developed, because that child will develop and become an adult and the nation will come up, come alive. So I cannot say women are more formidable unless you are not a disciplined woman or you are not cultured or you are not properly brought up, then you can become wolf or anything. But I was born by a woman. And the woman who gave birth to me happens to be a woman and a man at the same time. It cross all your dobugi. Oh, why you call woman? Okay, why? That is why she became Lola before she passed. And that thing she gave us, we have it. And our word will be failed here. Coming back to what you are saying, Mazi, let me tell Biafran this. It is so much in my heart. My heart, not because of what I see happening, is because of the Biafrans that I see in Obibo that are being killed by Yesomuike, Mr. Yesomuike, because he's not a governor. That is what makes my heart bleed. But if you ask me what my heart bleeds because of our people, and somebody is here telling Biafrans it's all about me, it's all about him. It is not all about you. It is not all about you. It is all about the restoration of Biafra and the freedom of our people. And God gave this man the mantle of leadership, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, to do this job. Mazi Obilo, remind me of, because I am emotionally, somehow. But I don't show emotion. Remind me what you said last, please.
All right. What I said was, according to our leader, he said that 100 men only.
Thank you. Let me go. Let me take it from there.
All right.
Go back to the book of Judges. You see, man will propose, but God will dispose. Listen, the book of Judges, there's a man called Gideon, one of the judges of Israel. He was selected and called by God to lead his people, to liberate his people. In those days, they used to have conflict with other clan or nations or tribes. And he was leading them. But at a time, there were many. So he had a communication with Elohim. Elohim said to him, the people you have with you are too many. I want you to send them back. He said, what? He said to Elohim, I need more people even. Elohim said, no, you have more than enough. And the people you have, the men you have are no men. I want to show you what I mean. So he told, you know, and they began to do this test and do this test. Eventually, he said, okay, you know, how are you going to do it? Go take them to the river. They will be thirsty. They will be thirsty to drink. While they are drinking, pick those ones that are lapping the water with your hands. Those ones that are lapping the water with their hands. The one that put their heads inside the water and be drinking and are careless. They don't look around. They don't wash out. They don't know. They don't observe. Select them and put them aside. The one that take the water with their hands and be looking around while they're drinking. Keep them by the other side. And when he did conducted that operation, he only picked 300 that were lapping with their hands and were washing. A lot of people didn't know that it's because of observation that made those 300 people to be qualified. And how many thousand? There are many thousands of people. He sent them home. Can you imagine that? And God said, go with these 300 specialists. They will give you what you're looking for. And those 300 specialists went with Gideon and they did exploit, they conquered their enemies. I call them specialists. You know, in the military, they have different categories of military units. So they in America, they call them SEALs. They are SEALs. Those are the ones that went to Faisalabad, where Osama bin Laden was hiding, and they did damages on him. Those are the particular unit Gideon took. Those are specialists. Some countries call them specialists. They do everything. They can come on air. They can, if they land with parachute and land inside the sea, they're going to swim out. They master the sea. They master the air. If they come on the land, they will be running. They don't get tired. If they come to the desert, they will adapt to the temperature. They will navigate their way out of desert. Those are specialists. If they come to the midst of where people are, they will discipline themselves. You will know whom they are. They are specialists. If they go closer to the enemy, they know how to take the enemy out without screaming and shouting. They are specialists. So you see what I'm talking about. These are the things you will use to know who is truly. It could be, I'm not Elohim. Elohim spoke to our leader, and our leader followed the directives. And we can see clearly that indeed Elohim communicated and is still communicating with this man. So he said to us that these people are coming. When they said they budgeted 670 million to go and use their equipment and jam our radio, and you guys believe that it's going to be technological warfare, if you're listening to this, you get confused. That money you see are the things that you are seeing today. Their communicating network that they're going to jam is to use that money and flash you, you fall. You know, when they were telling Mazi before, why do you flaunt radio when you are still not done with what is going on, what's going on. Freedom Fighting Radio, I said, he was speaking from both sides of his mouth, as he always says. And the person who was there is the one who always come on air to say people, to say to people, our leader is a very, very formidable man. He's a good man. If this is the one who was there and getting, and somebody was calling our leader a liar. This man, I know him, I've been in UK, I know what he's doing. I told Biafran that IPOB, led by Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, gave Ushemi for his status, UN passport, before he began to apply for this British passport, that whether he has gotten it or on the process to getting it, it could be one of the things they promised they would give him, and this and that, if you can only do this. He came up before, he couldn't, he ran inside his shell. He never showed any compassion and remorse to our people, to the people he said he's represented. I am really, really upset with this man. I damn everything about that man from where he came from. I damn it. And anyone that loves freedom, liberation will do the same thing. It is not about me. If they tell me to step down, whatever, whatever thing, which I don't have anything though, I will just go and be supporting. I love what our leader is doing. He has achieved so much in this trouble. I don't need to get updates. Tell me where you are. Then let me know where we are in the struggle. Let me do this. No, if I begin to ask that question, that means I want to sell the information to someone else. If you trust your leader, you trust him. Dear friends, do you trust our leader? Do you love him? I remember when he came from that area where he, after this Operation Python Dance, that almost took his life. When he came here, our national coordinator, I said, let all of us contribute money and give him welcome. I started with mine first. I know how that account was closed. I know everything they did, these people. The only thing I can say to these people, Elohim will destroy all of you. You crossed the line. Elohim will destroy all of you. 100 men are the things. Not that all those people back home are not relevant. You are relevant. But these 100 men have special thing they can offer. Just like I said to us, in the military, they have military police, the military army, the one that wear red beret. They have commandos. They have other units. The corporal. They have sergeants. They have their functionality. They have majors. They have major generals. They have generals. You can be general when you have mastered every act of combat and military. You can't not do general because they know nothing. It's just like late Idi Amin that gave himself field marshal, when he doesn't even know what sergeant knows. Field marshal that sleeps with women around. Idi Amin even sleeps with women in the car. Indiscipline field marshal. So if you use the eyes of the zoo to kind of look into the ranking and the units in the military or in the police or intelligence service, you will get confused because they don't have it. They have the names, but they don't have the discipline, the qualification to get that, to do that job. That's why they are confused. So this is what general does. If you are a specialist, you can go to a mission, deliver that mission, and come back alive. You're a specialist. If you're not a specialist, you will go to that mission and you will be telling them that mosquito beat you, cockroach beat you. You had sustained this wound from mouse because you were sleeping in the bush. And you don't have money, you don't have any money to feed yourself. I am not driving. And he went and got himself 4x4 and started broadcasting to show the world that he has arrived. Pierre Prince gave you what you have. So before you say a word, give them back what they gave you. Give Biafrans what they gave you. Give us what we gave you. You want to come and tell us that you have arrived. I remember when I was giving offering, the one in America was asking me, why are you giving such money? Imagine that. If somebody is giving offering, you pray for him, as our leader used to do. He will pray for you, send recorded voice prayer to you, that Namda Gozigi. That is more than enough. And you started, these people didn't start today. So I'm not surprised. When I had the news, I said to them, minus problems. I don't know how many problems there are. Minus problems. If I begin to talk about these people, time will fail all of us. But I am in the family. I saw everything. So most people talking on air, I'm talking on what the person I'm seeing here. The people that I'm seeing that doesn't, they think if you have little money and you have qualification and this and that, you are being approached, you have arrived. You don't know how many people that sent calls on my communication gadget, that the one I used to do broadcast, but I don't pick them, I know them. Some have come from Saudi Arabia. Some have come from Dubai. I don't pick their call. The system will tell me where the caller is calling from. Ngiara. You don't think about your people. So 100 men, our leader was told who those 100 men are. I don't know about his 100 men, but I know about Gideon's 100 men. What God told him. He said, anyone that is drinking with observation, you have to observe. You have to be vigilant if you're in the military. You have to observe if you are in an assignment. Observation will give you precision where the enemies are. So when you set up whatever you use to attack them, if you put the missile, it will be precise. It will hit the target. Don't let me train you on air. So if you don't have that observation capability to observe and to endure pain, to endure humiliation, to endure backbiting, to endure name calling, to endure disturbances, because definitely Biafrans will disturb you. Some will call you names. And those things, you will count them as nothing. Your eyes are focused on the enemy and on the target. You don't present your case. How they treated you, how they sidelined you, how they took up the password from you. This is a big disappointment. Shows that you are shy. And you are telling me you want to be my deputy. You want to be my deputy? I never seen ANC having deputy leader of ANC. Mandela was the leader. Madiba was the leader and he fought gallantly. He has men. Flash anything you want to flash. These guys won't listen to you. Even the kids, I don't know about today, because some are getting corrupted. They won't listen to you. They come for you, they take you. Because you are killing their people. And here you are. Your people are dropping dead. Nike is killing them. You never come out to talk about the killings, the massacring, the humiliation they are doing to Biafrans. Because you have relative in the government, you think you are the only one. When the time comes, I will showcase to you that I have full army cousins. You don't know. I didn't hate them. I hate the system of Niger area. I hate the system. I have somebody from my family that married to a Fulani, speaks Fufude, knows even the Buhari himself. I don't want to disclose them, put them in danger. But I hate the system. I told them that I hate the system. And the man said, there is nothing he can do because he's just a servant to them. Imagine that. And because you have somebody, I have people, ministers even. I don't communicate with them. I don't need anything from them. And you are telling me that Mazi Obino, 100 men is what Elohim told our leader. I don't know who those men are. I don't know the characteristics God gave him. He's washing every one of us. I don't know. So might as well be there. If anything, if you come to the, if you ask me anything about the letter that you are talking about, I will finally explain the letter briefly to you.